Good afternoon, people. It's 1:05, June 10, 2014, and I may not make any more videos for a while after I do this video, because I've been devoting a lot of my time to unraveling the so-called mystery of God that's spoken of in Revelations chapter 10. And you're going to hear a lot of thundering in the background, because it's the seven thunders that are speaking so that the work can be finished. And you're going to notice that in most of my videos, a lot of my videos, I gave y'all certain types of hints and certain ways to go into directions that will lead you out of their contrived matrix. But I've come up with some more information. And those that did this to my brain, my objective is not to judge any race, species, because I truly am high. And this is about judging co-creator gods, lesser gods. And I'm going to read at Psalms 82. So if I've offended any people, I'm sorry, but it does boil down to these races that are trying to dominate. It's not so much an EB race either. It's right here on this planet, and I'm going to break it down to y'all so y'all can understand what is taking place here and how we're going to abyss Satan simply with truth. Let's read Psalms 82. God presides in the great assembly. He gives judgment among the gods. How long will you defend the unjust and show partiality to the wicked? Selah. Defend the cause of the widow and the fatherless. Maintain the rights of the poor and oppressed. Rescue the weak and needy. Deliver them from the hand of the wicked. They know nothing, they understand nothing. They walk about in darkness. All the foundations of the earth are shaken. I said, you are gods. You are sons of the Most High, but you will die like men. You will fall like every other ruler. Rise, O God, judge the earth, for all the nations are your inheritance. And I'm going to show you how all the nations are the inheritance of the sovereign highest in the heavens. And I'm going to break something down with these tribes. Remember we discussed Ara? Ara means high. It means noble. It means altar. High, noble, altar. Then we have the factions of the Arapa, which is a native Indian nation. Then we have Ara, or Aram, Aramanians, which is from the Middle East. And then there's this faction of the Aramawi, which is the Sabahs. And they are the Egyptian Kemet faction. And as history goes, I've gone digged a little bit back. This is actually high science. So we've got a black faction and a white faction that has been battling. You can call them the Anunnakis, and then you can call the black faction the Sabahs race, or the Kemets of Egypt. Now I'm going to set matters straight right now with these factions, because it looks like Yakub, who the Sabahs say was the inventor of the white race, which is just putting it out here, people. I took some looks at this supposedly god Yakub, and he looks like the Klingon from Star Trek to me. He does. Now, what I've learned from the Yakubs, or the Sabahs, is They're the inventors of the Allah God, which is a moon god. But they are the actual ones that brought the paganism into this earth realm with the genetic experiments, and that's how you got your Egyptian gods. You see the falcon-headed gods. You see, all of those came from the Kemets. Now, mind you, Ra means noble. We also have the caste system of Aryan, which just means noble. So what has happened is we've got black men fighting with white men or white people because the black man feels that they created the white man from this scientist, high scientist called Yakub. Now, we have the Asiatic and African mix of people that they are trying to make claims to. I look maybe Asiatic African, but my DNA and blood culture is not that at all. Looks can be very deceiving. It's in my blood, it's not that, and they know it. And if they thought I wasn't going to figure out why that I had them pyramids and lights and was gonna try to blame it on the Greys have been ratting on y'all. Mm-hmm. Y'all, the Nazis conjured the Greys up they conjured them. And what did the race of Sabaz conjure? Huh? What did the Egyptians do? It looks like we have two factions here at war, which Kevin calls the black and white Hebrews. And if I want to say Hebrew, I call them male witches. Arapah and Aramanians are of the same lineage, the Turks, or the Turkish, they come from the East, the Native American Indians. And so now y'all want to sit here and say that the Asians and the Native American, Mexican, Hispanic type people are the creations, y'all lab creations? I'm not buying that at all. And y'all hear the thunder in the background. We about to settle this. All Aryan means is noble. And we have a few people now, or a few factions that are not considered noble. We have the Slavic, which would be the Germans, which would be the Nazi, Anunnaki, Aldebaran type faction here, warring with the black Kemets, Aramawis, over who's more superior. So that's another code here I done gave to y'all people concerning these words that I just used. You can go in and you can research who are now causing some serious problems in society and on this planet. And they are considered lesser gods, but Aram, Aramania, the Syriacs, Mesopotamia, that is the middle way. The Middle East is the middle way. And you'll notice that the Yakubs or the Sabaz and the Anunnaki, they don't like to give credit to Lord Yeshua. They don't. They don't think that he was from the true God at all. But Babylonia acknowledges that the tribe of Shem, of Aram, of the Middle East, and they are the Middle Eastern glory of Ara. And Ara is a star system, people. Now, what happened here in North America with the Arapaho Nation, because like I told you, there's more than 12 tribes. And right is right and wrong is wrong. No race is superior than the other. And no one should be using high magic and high science on the population. Genetically altering and experimenting with others. So, we've got the Greys, who's probably were created through the Anunnazis, the Nazis. And then we've got the Shabazz tribe, who are against Yakub, who they say created the Asians and mixed them with African and came up with the natives and then said they created the white man. Now you see how crazy this is? And they thought, by lacing my brain and doing what they did to my mind, I wouldn't figure it out. There's a lot of things I knew and understood, and they had no business doing this. But what it really all boils down to is the lesser gods, which they know I'm part of. The assembly of the gods is what's being judged here, not humanity, not mankind. You have us in the middle of this. And I'm saying us and we because I'm in a form of, I'm brown. I'm one of the brown ones. I'm not blue black, I'm not black. And I'm not pale white pink skinned. I'm brown. I'm in the middle, I guess. Just like most of the Middle East, most of the native tribes. Most of Mexican, you know, the Hispanics were the brown people that y'all think y'all created. And I'm glad that I'm born like looking like this now. Now I have a reason to really judge you fallen angels for trying to make the black man more superior and then trying to make the white man more superior. So y'all need to get it together and let the truth be known concerning Ara, which means noble, noble born. And what proves that you're noble is your deeds of love and kindness. That's how you prove you're noble, not by your wars. So, like I said, the kingdom belongs to all races, all colors, all creeds. And y'all did do a really bad thing to me, knowing y'all did it to bid for time. And I just showed you people on this internet that when you trump from the true one, from the highest, ain't nothing they can do to you to stop you from your purpose. And Jody will never be scared of fallen angels or giants, ever. So y'all, let's wake up. And they're going away. The Middle East created something that was really, really wonderful. And the Orthodox and Coptic Christians do know that Christ is universal, and that the church, the literal church, is your family.